So I have something now that I've been waiting to stream for some time. There's a person in chat who really wants me to stream this, and so I'm not. No, it's like the game I want to play is something I've been holding on to for a while, and there's another game I've been thinking about playing. It's Bird Museum, and I know Casual Bird in chat and various other bird-like people in chat with bird names, avian names, would like to see me stream the Bird Museum. I've gotten requests for it. However, please be patient on Bird Museum. I might not be able to get to it tonight. I want to stream Quantum Eternity instead. What's Quantum Eternity? I don't know. Hello, welcome to the Chronoverse. This is a dream game inspired by LSD Dream Emulator and 21 The World. Please enjoy. I like both of those games. I love both of those games, I should say. Speaking of, I had another fucking weird dream last night that I wrote down. So, this is a fitting time to tell you about it. Wait a minute, I was gonna say, is this the area you fight in Devil May Cry 3? Oh shit. Yeah, LSD Dream Emulator got a full English translation, by the way. Which, is very interesting. That could be a revisit at some point in the future. What is that? Everything here is appropriately weird, but then there's that. Yeah, this is bitrate slaying. Someone said you truly cannot get more Sunday than this. Yeah, pretty much. That's why I had this on hold for a little while, but I knew deep down this was something that needed to be, explored. Oh shit, it's Blathers. Oh. Oh shit. Is this death? Does this area represent, like, me having died? I wonder. What was my dream? I'll tell you... I was gonna say, I'll tell you at the appropriate area with the appropriate sound effects. And here I am in the fucking clown zone. The penis clown zone. This is not where I'm gonna tell you my dream. This is literally an area from LSD. Yep. Oh shit. Yeah, you can see both the LSD Dream Emulator and the, 21 The World influence. This is Tom Waits. Man, I gotta listen to more Tom Waits. Pengu. Chrono Distillation Tower. This tower was erected to contact the deep space chronosphere that allows the harnessing of time travel. Necros Tower at the North Pole and Santos Tower in the South Pole. The Quantite crystal placed at the top of the tower fell to Earth, predicted to be from the chronosphere. Is used to be used to contact the chronosphere. What? The returning signal is then used to allow the use of time travel. This power was discovered by New Wartst of the University of Iceland in 2019. The fuck am I reading? I'm still waiting for the right area to tell my dream. I'm not ready yet. Even though this music is pretty good. I'm sorry, you like bitrate? Yeah, we don't have that here on the stream. We don't have any of that. Tree people. Treeb. You begin to feel your legs turning into roots. Well, I love the time of day. The secret Bowie song, it makes you feel that way. I don't know what this music is. It sounded like the intro to a weird Bowie song circa Ashes to Ashes. Uh-oh, I think the game froze. No, it didn't. This is a good area for my dream. I'll tell you the dream now. I was an actor on Always Sunny, doing a scene with a famous actress. However, I didn't prepare, and I didn't know my lines. While in the scene, I freaked out and had to go through the script, but couldn't find my lines. Turns out I only had a couple, but not only could I not memorize them in the dream, but the pages of the script were out of order, so I couldn't find them again. All this while the pressure was on me completely. I was holding up production. There's also a script book, but the pages were out of order in that too. Everyone was waiting for me to get my shit together, but I couldn't. I woke up in a sweat. That's what I wrote down. And I really did. I remember I woke up in a fucking cold sweat. And it just kept going. And I don't know who the famous actress was, but she was like kind. And Rob McElhenney, who plays Mac, was getting really pissed at me. But every time I was like, what page are your lines on? She would tell me like 237. And then I would go to 237 and I couldn't find it because it was out of order. Hang on a second. And then then I would say, okay, I couldn't find my lines again. And then I would say, wait, what page again? And then it would be like, well, 276. So then I would look around and the script, every page was completely out of order. And every time I looked down at the script, it was in a different order every time. It was a fucking nightmare. And I spent what seemed like an hour in the dream just trying to find my lines. And I remember finding my lines at one point, and it was like two lines, but I couldn't remember them. This is the Sauron blood bagel. Yeah, it was a really fucking interesting dream. Reading and text doesn't really work in dreams. No, it doesn't. What were the lines? I don't remember them. Oh, we were in a classroom, weirdly enough. The scene took place in a classroom, and this right here just triggered that memory. To the nostalgia zone, where all the things that you remember from your childhood are now gone. Meme City, Spoop Town. I want to go to there. I don't have any cocoa. Vinny, you definitely played a game with this exact layout. This could have fucking fooled me, but I play lots of games. Maybe it's just like the same developer. Yeah, it's probably just like a rip from that as like a little joke area. I wonder if there's an alternate way out of here. Yeah, I love these weird dream emulator type games where you have to... You just keep playing. Just discover areas, go to the right spots, find new areas. I don't know. There's just something about this type of gameplay. It's not just for Sunday stream, but in general. I find them fascinating. As Mr. Skok would say. Sorry. Do you remember that game I played with these masks on the wall? Didn't have Majora's Mask, I don't think, but there was a game. Was it 21 the World? It was 21 the World. It was. Is that... That's Skyrim. And that is supposed to be... Westeros? Wait. What's this one? It's Mario, but as Scotland? My ears, goddamn. I've said this before while playing 21 the World, but if I could make a game, I would make a game like this. Like, just for fun, not to sell. Not for any specific reason, just weird areas linked together. Dreams. Just strange shit that occurs to me. I'd make, like, the classroom dream. You know the weird dream notebook I've been keeping? I would just take scenes from that and put them into levels. Which I'm sure this is, as 21 the World was, and LSD Dream Emulator was. As you can tell, I'm a big fan of dreams in general. And the game dreams as well, but... Just, dreams are weird and good. And have given me some good songs. I'm indebted to dreams. Cammy Koopa's theme from Paper Mario. The original? N64? Yeah, I've only played through that once. I've mentioned the possibility of streaming it at some point. Vinny, do you have recurring locations in your dreams? Yes, many. There's, a mall that is not like one I've been to, but is like a kind of an amalgamation of several malls. There's a strip mall. You're noticing a trend? There's a park There's a high school / college hybrid. That is kind of like the ones I went to, but it not really. That was like 90s Bowie drum and bass. Someone said in chat, I'm freaking out. That's when you watch everything Jonathan Frakes has ever been in one night. Which you can't, but you could try. You need multiple TVs. Never happened. Vinny, this game makes you think of Bowie a lot. Yeah, it does. Yeah, it kind of does. How did you get your dreams vivid enough to write them down to begin with? Sometimes I can go a week or two without being able to write one down. But melatonin certainly helps. Yeah, melatonin and also writing them down. Getting into a habit of writing them down actually makes it a little easier to remember them. So, if I go through my dream journal, which again is just a notepad on my phone, because it's the easiest, and also I don't have to turn a light on. I could just dictate, you know, I could just, like, speak the dream. But if I check here, I've got about 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, about 20 dreams since February, including Dietlmoors. Underwater swamp on the way to pizza. Jim Carrey quizzes me on the dinosaur that was in the water. And of course, Martin Scorsese, my most famous dream, Martin Scorsese as a stick insect. And that was my favorite one. I remember we were talking and he started out as Martin Scorsese. But as we were talking and walking together, talking about movies and shit, he just kept shrinking and morphing into a stick insect, but it was totally normal. In the dream, I did not question it, and eventually he just started, like, eating some leaves and blending in with the leaves. And that was in a recurring location, which is, that reminded me, two more recurring locations. There's an island. That's like a hilly mount, like, island that is like almost like it was in the Bahamas, but it's not, with a central street and a couple of stores and several other, like, houses. So there's a hilly island, and then that location was at a street where there was a fake studio. It was that dream, oh my god. Even just talking about this. Like, I'm remembering several other locations. Oh, hello. I wonder if they had any inclination that I'd be streaming this. And if so, thanks. And yes, I know the world doesn't revolve around me, but... you know, I play a lot of shit like this. You gotta make a pizza world if you know I'm streaming it. Bonus points for pizza world. The calzone. For some reason that melody reminded me of Long Slow Goodbye by Queens of the Stone Age, just for a second there. This is where they're born. Teletubby Moon.
Every now and then of the glorious fruit of the noble hen. Eggs! E-double-G-S eggs. My knowledge of eggs is...
I am in a brain.
I've eaten them boiled, I've eaten them fried.
Jesus. That was a rare area. That was not an easy area to get to. Yeah, that's... my brain is similar to that. Eggs, Majora's Mask Moon, the Strange Moon. There's like a weird calming flow to these games where... you go through fucking batshit crazy areas, and then every now and then, like, it just deposits you in an area that's just chill. So I went to the owl last time. This person... and the person who made 21 the World should team up for a game and have Tommy Wiseau give ideas. And then you go from batshit insane to fucking transcendental. Hey man, my name is Mike Love, and I was in TM. I did TM, Transcendental Meditation, with George Harrison, my good friend George Harrison. He was in the Beatles, name drop the Beatles. My name is Mike Love, I am the Beach Boys. Chat, Mike Love put out a new song with John Stamos during this quarantine. And it's embarrassing. It's really bad, chat. It's really not good. What's it called? I don't know. I don't remember. Was it called Skeet Surfing? No, but, I guarantee you Skeet Surfing was a better song than this. I'll play it after I'm done checking this game out. That was death. Called This Too Shall Pass. Yeah, it's like, it's really, it's like what the rhymes, your first song that you write in elementary school. No, not this. Not this. Here, I'll play the song while I'm going through this hallway, so it won't get claimed. Let's see how many likes it has on YouTube. And dislikes. Let's see, 2 days ago. Pretty high, actually, surprisingly.
Was a cause for celebrations. Nobody ever even thought about closing down entire nations. Washing hands and wearing a mask, and it's not even Halloween. Shaking hands is a thing of the past due to social distancing. People are wondering how long it'll last. As the saying goes, this too shall pass. Well, I believe the best is yet to come. So let's get back to having fun, fun, fun in the sun.
Wow, that was mixed really well.
In the meantime, people, there can be no doubt. Lots of folks deserve a big shout out. First responders and the National Guard. Doctors and nurses all working real hard. It's kind of like a viral Super Bowl.
Okay, I can't listen to, and not just because of copyright claims, I can't do it. I get, like, the sentiment, I get, obviously, that's a good, like, thank you, everybody that's helping out, I get that. Sorry. I promise you, the Beach Boys, led by Brian Wilson, in the mid-60s and the late-60s was very good. Don't confuse that with what the Beach Boys were when they were at their best. Yeah, it's weird. Every now and then I can't jump. So that's a problem. Like, my jumping is taken away from me. Oh. Vinny, smile or pet sounds? I'm partial to the smile sessions, but I think pet sounds is kind of amazing. I also like Friends, the album Friends, and I like a lot of singles. I'm a big fan of Surf's Up. I think that's a great album. It's a dark album. It's a really sad, fucked up album. Sunflower's good. Ross or Chandler? Hmm. I don't have an answer to that question. Probably Michael Scott. No, I'm more of a Jerry guy. Jerry Seinfeld. No, Kramen. No, Kramlet. It's George. I'm just naming like sitcom characters. Frasier. You begin to feel the pull of the hallucination. Speaking of, I wonder if I can get to that portal by the time, before these part. God damn it. Doesn't seem like there's a way to do that. Shit. Okay, that's death. That brought me back to the death cave. Shit. The first responders and the National Guard. We all remember when school was out. All right, I'm done. Okay, I'm gonna actually end the stream in a bit because it's late. But this is a really cool one of these games, and I'm sure I missed plenty of things. Tree of peace and love. And violence. Well, you know. Sorry. You know, we went on a retreat to the Maharishi. You know, George and I. And Mike Love was there. And I put it on. Put me glove on, because I had lost it in India. I went all the way back to get it. Guess there's nothing I could do up there. Yeah, the coin glove. I can't do coin gloves anymore right now because gloves are at a premium. I don't know where to get them. That won't take 2 months to deliver them. Or I don't want to spend like $450 for a pair of gloves. You know, disposable. Alright, well, I'm gonna go to that green crystal and that'll be it. Whatever's over there. Oh, right, okay. Back to Morrowind. big pile of rocks over there. Damn it. Okay. It's hard to stop playing this, because you always want to see what's next. Yeah, well, anyway, I think I'm going to stop. This is definitely a Sunday-ass Sunday game, and I'm sure some of this was inspired by dreams, so I can always appreciate something like that. Let's talk to the owl one more time. Oh, there's this area. I didn't spend a lot of time here. Hang on, almost done. Found a bed. Would you ever revisit this game if it gets an update? I would. Yeah, like 21 The World, I just kept revisiting every time it got updated. So yeah, I would probably revisit this. So Tom Waits, right? I don't know what the song sounds like, but it's probably something like, I don't know where you've been going! Down the hole, baby! Also, good morning. Sorry about that. I woke a lot of people up, it looks like. I mean, Tom Waits impressions at 3:30 a.m., that's just part of life. That's part of stream. Is this FTL music? Also, we found plenty of new things. We've been here once. Yeah, I ended the stream, but now I'm still going, so that's cool. Oh, right, there's a portal here. Oh, fuck. Fuck, I'm stuck on the stairs, and I have to... Wait, maybe this will push me through. I don't want to have to touch the succulent. I got it, portal. And we've been here already. Alright, so we've seen... We've seen most things. I don't know how many things we've seen compared to how many things are in this game, but it feels like we've seen at least a lot of it. It's the clown zone, but without the clown tunes. Someone in chat said, you haven't even started to begin. I really like that sentence. Well, that was Quantum Eternity. Genuinely enjoyable dream emulation. Really, really good stuff. Thank you for watching. I promise Bird Museum will eventually be shown. Bird Museum is something that I've been looking forward to checking out. I don't know, you know, I think it's just birds. So I guess that's cool. There's bird fans in chat. Everybody, here's the art. This guy we're sick made this. Cafe Butti. Today's offerings, cog au vin, served. Okay. Meatballs yao diavolo. Traditional Staten Island balls in a Sicilian sauce. Main piquito crab with Granny Smith apples, celery, and toasted hazelnut. You're out. I'm in. People want more Vin. Seek64 made this. Nice. Hey, smelly head. You fucking stink. That's basically what happened in RimWorld yesterday, and also Scoot. Saying, is that a toe, or am I still high? Very nice. Sam J made this. Wow. Is this the Bermuda Triangle, but Scoot? I don't know what the hell's going on here. Looks like Long Island in the corner. It says, one quadrant of the Indian Ocean has been of particular interest to scientists and hobbyists alike. Knob's Peak? It's famous because there's a strange auditory phenomena. Radio systems close to the marine quadrant have been able to receive low-frequency sounds, which, when pitch-adjusted and sped up, sound like mysteriously like the call of a bird. Curiously, the island of Knob Peak experiences shifts in the underground tectonic plates, much like earthquakes. The sounds emanating from the ocean quadrant seem to coincide with these plate shifts. This phenomenon remains unexplained, and it serves as an interesting and fun diversion for those seeking a mystery while on the seaside, on a seaside cruise. It's Scoot. Very nice. Alyssa made this. It's Scoot. And me. And Scoot. Also very nice. Snorlax Bud made this. Where is my lung, Miku? Where is old? Why are you crying? Yeah. It's been a bad couple RimWorlds, I'll tell you that much. Some not fun things have happened. Noodle made this. So this is Dreeb and Miku's fight. This happened. And then Miku had to take care of Dreeb. If you're not watching the RimWorld streams, I get it. It doesn't look like an exciting game because it's all, you know, kind of text and like very simple graphics. But my god, the drama that happens in RimWorld. This is a thing made this. It said they made a chiptune cover of In the Garden. I don't always want to hear my own music, even in chiptune version, but I'll listen to it for a little bit. Here's one from Kitty Shipper Cave Girl. I'm gonna judge the accuracy of this, by the way. Pretty good. Anyway, this was the sarcophagus that was built for Old. Old's love. So far, so good. Yeah, I mean, you can see it, it's written what was supposed to be there, and it was a fucking insane mess of things. It's good. This one's from Cicero the King. Let's see if you got the chorus right. Yeah, good ear. I've heard some, chiptune covers. Let's see if you got the end. You got it. You did a good job with that. I think you nailed it. You have a really good ear. Yeah, so this one's from Cicero the King, and it's a BRB with Scoot dancing, and I like that. I can definitely use that. I'll probably be streaming Animal Crossing tomorrow, until about... It might be like a really early Animal Crossing stream, like well, not really early, but like 2:33, something like that. And then, I'll do another stream later on. One of those, you know? So, this one's from Phoenix Seraph. Zippy, zippy, zoomy, zoomy. Tifa, what the fuck is a zip zoom? Dilly dally, shilly shally cloud. Oh, nice. Speaking of, wow, good timing. Cloud's face in this is amazing. Here's one from Bhagwandi Raman. And it's Miku with the Pizza Hut. But yeah, it's another of Old's Love, the Sarcophagus. Which was just the name of it. Just generated randomly. Strange. Here's one from Andromeda. Nice interpretation too. I like that. Here's a Sunday BRB. Excellent work. Can use that. Definitely. This one's from Shanguin. Banana Scoot. is that a fair in the background? Italian man wins Rasta Duck Banane at the boardwalk. Oh, wait, so I played some boardwalk games. I played the coin game in Wildwood, New Jersey, and won a banana, giant banana plush Scoot. I get it. Now, here's the thing, though. Will these... I want to go on my vacation again this year. And, is that going to happen? Are we going to be able to do things? Oh, God damn it. I don't think I'm going to be able to do that. Can I go to Madagascar for vacation? Do they open up the ports? Anyway, nice work, nice art. Here's one from Uralis. Here's a BRB with a shroom girl and a meat. No, it's a slime. Yeah, it's slime. This is Champion's art. Is what it is. Very nice. Here's one from Fredolin. And this is the Kill It With Fire game I played earlier. This is essentially what happened. Like, pretty much exactly what happened, mind you. Very nice interpretation. Great art. Here's one from Zatro. Smooth Spider Demon. Shooting minigun. It's also, oh, it's a Doom Eternal crossover. Yep. Yeah, I get it. It's good. Pajama 114 made this. It's from GBA Prototypes. It's a Vine Shroom. It's a face. With the fucking tree face. That goddamn tree face. This one's from Gross Forgot the Password Again. How many passwords have been forgotten? Because I'm assuming there was also Gross Forgot the Password. Right? So now if there's Gross Forgot the Password Again, that means that this is the third one. That's just a guess. But anyway, in the void, Banjo Pilots. This was a thing that actually really happened. There was like a brief Well, not brief, but there were a couple moments during Banjo Pilot. This is the third one. But the second one was grossy. Okay, I get it. Alright, well, sorry you had to make a new account. But yeah, you can green screen this out. You can do all kinds of cool shit. I'll show you. So, watch this. Cool, right? But yeah, there was Banjo against the Void, of course. This one's from Amoral Crow. Here's Miku. Crow, you know, your art is always top-notch, but this is just amazing. I'm a great doctor, says Miku, smoking a joint while Scoot is also smoking a joint. And putting the anesthesia on old, about to face the Void. This is the Rimworld, the past two Rimworld streams in a nutshell, chat. I don't think it's chloroform. I think it was just general, you know, anesthesia, trying to get old nice and comfortable for the operation. And as we know, that didn't go so great. This is just next level. Amoral Crow. I can't wait for people to see your work on the album. Just saying. I don't know when it'll happen, but looking forward to it. This one's from Ladderbug. I didn't say soon. There's no work getting done right now, chat. I don't have a timeline, I'm sorry to say. So, I'm sorry to get your hopes up. What I mean to say is Amoral Crow did the artwork, and I really am very pleased with it. So, I got nothing for you right now. I'm sorry. I'll let you know when I got something. This one's from Ladderbug. And here is... So it's me attacking spiders. And then the DLC, of course, centipede tanks. Excellent. I would play that DLC in a second. Great art. Here's one from Agusata. So, wait, what's going on here? You took the face, and you made it into Kermit, and then you made it into Scoot. There are so many good faces. If anyone else had found a good face tonight, like, from the stream, please, like, you know, send it to me, tweet it to me, whatever you gotta do. I got the tree face, and I got this face. So, these are very cursed images, by the way. I missed one before. Massive Sweaty Bucket of Butter, which is an excellent name, made this. It's... what? Dilbert Vineshroom? Octopus? Oh, what the hell's going on here? Cosmo Canyon could not have come at a better time. Or one of the Cosmo Canyon tracks. Sock Puppet Kingdom made this. Here's Frog Dude. The, you know, least... sadly appreciated, least appreciated mascot of all time. Vinny, it's Red 13's, song? I should know that, shouldn't I? Me, big Final Fantasy fan. Yeah. The least marketable mascot ever, said someone in chat. However, Frogger really worked out. Amaris made this. Vinios. It's good. What's in there? Flies, pizza, shrooms. Are those... what else is in there? Just trash in general, I guess. Yeah, just bags of trash. Here's a BRB from Two Bros Studios. This fucking art. Every now and then, this art shows up. You know, someone does a version of this. And it's always great. Really great Final Fantasy VIII song. Big fan of the guitar sound. Yeah, chat, you're gonna love the Balam Garden remade in VR, chat. It's really good. It's really well done. Vinny, have you noticed that you have a spliff? Oh, that's V-dub. That's not me. Oh, fuck. How many dreebs do we have here? There's a Poggers, there's Twitch chat, there's Miku, there's Alpaca. It's Rimworld, basically. Dreeb splitting into two guys, the blunt in the middle for Scoot. There's so much detail here. I love it. Meta Yoro made this. Here's Frog Dude again. The brain was smooth. I didn't even catch that detail, but we'll see it during a BRB. So Frog Dude returns. And from Freeze Storm, let us defy destiny together. Wouldn't you want to alter the plot? Spoilers. Wait a minute. Altering the plot? You threw away the script, didn't you? That's why all the pages are scattered. Oh my god. So that's what happened. It's my dream, but Final Fantasy VII Remake. Oh my god. Well, that explains it. Alright. Good night, everybody. Thank you for watching. Have a good evening, night, day, whatever time it may be where you live. Appreciate you stopping by the stream and watching. You're very kind to me. During the week, I'll try to do some variety. Now that Final Fantasy VII Remake is sadly over, I will, the Trials of Mana, of course, try to stream Dreams this week, maybe a VR segment. I'd like to do a VR segment. Maybe more VR chat, if not this week, then soon, because we found some new worlds, and Udon, the programming language in VR chat, is making some pretty heavy strides. There's Spider-Man, you may have seen that on Ross's stream. There's all kinds of bizarre stuff, and there's games, and it's cool. So, yeah. The Noida update, maybe not this week, but eventually, I'd like to come back to that. And yeah, Cloudpunk would be nice. But yeah, take care once again. Please stay safe and sane, and, you know, take care of yourselves and each other, and I will see you tomorrow, Animal Crossing. And enjoy the rest of your evening, or good night, whatever you want to do. You can wait here for the auto host. It'll take you to a bunch of different streamers. You might enjoy them. They're my mods. They're my friends. They're good people that have helped me out and kept me sane and really, you know, help my life. So I appreciate them. They're not just mods. They're good friends of mine. So, good night. See you later.
Deserve a big shout out. First responders and the National Guard. Doctors and nurses all working real hard. It's kind of like a viral Super Bowl. So do unto others, it's good for the soul. All 50 states with a unified goal. God bless America, that's how we roll. People are wondering how long it'll last. As the saying goes, this too shall pass. Well, I believe the best is yet to come. So let's get back to having fun, fun, fun in the sun. We're turning lemons into lemonade. Just be cautious, don't be afraid. Do what the doctors recommend. The sooner we do, this pandemic will end. Shall pass. Well, I believe the best is yet to come. So let's get back to having fun, fun, fun in the sun.